Thanks.
I wasn't very quiet.
There's still a few of us.
Good idea.
Yeah.
this Easter Sunday worship. It's awesome to have you with us as we celebrate our risen Savior today. I saw a lot of you out by the fireplace down by the lake this morning. I promise that you will still hear a resurrection sermon. It'll just be a heck of a lot different than the one we saw a few hours ago. So we'll make sure to keep this interesting, motivating, powerful, full of God's resurrection power. Brothers and sisters, I'm so glad you're here. I've only got one announcement for you today. It is a celebration. And we, as you know, have been looking for a new music director slash choir leader. So brothers and sisters, I'd like to introduce you to our new choir leader music director who has unofficially started. Her first Sunday will be May the 1st, but let's give a warm welcome to Maria Baker.
Thank you.
Christian faith. Today we will be reciting together the Apostles' Creed. You will find on the PowerPoint behind me. Congregation, won't you join along? I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Time for our children's sermon today. So, where are my kids?
Right here.
Hello, Ella. How are you? Taylor, boys, how are we doing?
Good.
Good?
Good.
This is... Alright. Ella, I heard this, this wicked story this morning, that oftentimes you like to walk into church, and there's normally some mints waiting for you, right? And you came in last week and there were no mints. How did that make you feel, by chance? You can speak honest, I was telling about it. She shook her head, she gave me that look, and said, I was not happy. But we're gonna fix that right away. Because it's Easter Sunday, we're going to restore those mints. So I'm going to have some for you, I'm going to have some for the Taylor boys, but I want you to do something for me, okay? After the service, I want you to take this and put it back there so nobody runs out of mints in the future, okay? Perfect, there you go. Boys, you're welcome, man.
Mr. Jen.
All right. So this is a really easy Sunday for a children's sermon. You know why? Because Jesus is risen. That's the best part about it. Everything we believe in, it all comes to fruition. And in a little bit, the adults are going to hear in their sermon that the disciples, when they heard that Jesus' body was not there, you know what they did? They ran all the way there. They were so excited to go find out if this was true, they ran and ran and ran. How long, Henry, do you think you could run before you get tired?
A mile.
A mile, okay. Jack, what about you?
Around the whole earth. 25 times.
Around the whole earth.
The whole earth 25 times? Well, if that's not a younger brother, one up in the older brother, I don't know what it is. Ella, how long do you think you could run before you get tired? Really fast. 2 minutes. Halfway around your house for 2 minutes, full bore, and then you're done. That's pretty darn impressive. Running flat out for 2 minutes, do you think you could outrun the boys?
Yeah.
That was a look of sly confidence. Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. So if you really put everything into it, maybe 10 seconds to 2 minutes, but you're good for at least 2 minutes worth of running. Okay. Well, here's the thing. If y'all were really excited about something, I bet you could run and run and run until you got there, especially if there was a surprise at the end, right?
No.
Jack says no.
I wouldn't run.
You think not?
I would take a motorcycle.
He would be smart. He'd use a motorcycle to get there. Smart. Smart. I tell you, brothers,
It's cheating.
That's cheating, well, but here's the thing. It sounds like Jack, if you're using a motorcycle, and Ella, if you want to ride flat out for 2 minutes, and Henry, if you want to go all around the house, if there was a prize at the end, you'd run really fast to get there. You'd find a way, Jack, to get there really fast, right?
I'm going to take a fishing boat after.
He's going to say, you're going to take a fishing boat after to find the boat and go up. Amen. Perfect. So they will run in to get to the tomb, very excited, and realize he actually is risen. Their prize was there. Jesus was now all of it. He came to save us. He came to be part of everything we are going through. And this is one of those big days in the church. We just get together and we celebrate. But what would be a celebration without gifts? Not a good one, Jack. Not a good one. So we have a couple of gifts from the church for you guys, okay? And parents, grandparents, I've got a lot more bags, so I'm going to set these at the door as you exit. So if you've got kids or grandkids you want to give them to, please pass them on. So our gift from the church to all of you.
Thank you.
You're welcome, guys.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Can't have a party without gifts, right? I like Jack. He wanted to see what he got before he said thank you. Kids, happy Easter.
Thank you.
I don't know, actually. It's a launcher. Okay. See, I don't even know it's in the bag, but it's supposed to be a lot of fun. Will y'all pray with me? Happy Easter, guys. We love you. You want to pray with me?
Prayer hands.
And adults, if you will join me. Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you for today.
Thank you for today.
The greatest gift we can receive, your love. May we walk,
may we
run, and tell everyone of how great you are. Thank you for loving us. Amen. God, you are the greatest.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Eric Adams and Mary White, Ann Johnson, Aubrey and Betty Blanks, Aubrey Blanks.
Megan Wunderson. The Boston family.
This is the day, Lord, that you have made. This is the day, Lord, that started like many others before it, but yet with new promise. As the clouds broke and the sun crested the horizon, its beams could not be denied. A new day has dawned with new possibilities, new life, new creation, resurrection. Lord, everything we believe can be found on this day. When with confidence and complete faith and hope and confirmation, we say, He is risen! He is risen indeed! Lord, it's all because of you. And on a morning just like this, Lord, as we offer praise and thanksgiving to you, by the waterside or here in our church, we once again offer our prayers and the meditation. you, for those in our congregation, those in our extended Matoaka family, and those all across the world, Lord, that they may be touched by this, your day of days. Lord, be with this church, its people, those outside of these walls, that we may be in one communion with all. Lord, the prayers we've offered and those we've kept in our hearts, we place them at your feet as we join together in prayer to your Son, Thomas, name. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
Came to the tomb
and saw that the stone had been removed from it. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." And Peter and the other disciple set out and went to the tomb. The two of them were running together. The other disciple outran Peter, and he reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings there lying, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and he believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood outside the tomb weeping. And as she wept, she bent over to look back into the tomb. And at that moment she saw two angels in white, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and one at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and she saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was him. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will go and take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and she said to him in Hebrew, "Rabuni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go off to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and to your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. Brothers and sisters, this is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. The sermon will preach itself. It will preach itself. Somebody walked in this morning and said, "Well, Patrick, you've already preached on it this morning, so you don't have much else to say, amen?" To which I said, "Absolutely, I've seen it all at sunrise, but if any of you feel the Spirit and want to come up here and preach a Easter Sunday service, come on up." I told Dan and I would ask. Hey, when the Spirit catches and it pulls, hang on. Hang on. One day somebody's going to take me up on that. Don't know when, but someday somebody's going to take me up on that. This day will preach itself because it's all about who we are, what we say we believe. And Scripture says, you're right. All the questions we've had, all the times we've looked at Luke and John over the past couple of months, talking about this trip that Jesus is taking to Jerusalem and what it means, it all comes to fruition this morning. The fulfillment of the Scriptures. What was supposed to happen, what was going to happen, happened. And he is risen. He is risen indeed. Somewhere along River Road this morning, chances are there was a nurse who had just gotten off work. She was probably worn out. She probably had just worked 3 12s. She's probably exhausted. But sleep won't come quickly. Her mind's probably going to be racked with the patients she could care for, those that she could help improve, and those she could not. And the stress of what it's like being a nurse at this time in our country's history. She's probably going to get a couple hours sleep, and then she's got to turn around and start a day shift not too long in the future because, well, there's not a lot of nurses to go around much anymore. So chances are probably somewhere between 6 and 7 and up to 8 a.m., there's a tired nurse making her drive back to Matoaka from another long and painful shift at the hospital. There's probably a cop getting off the shift of working in Petersburg or Colonial Heights. Chances are, as he was on the night shift, he probably came up against a whole range of people from society. Those willing to respect his badge and what he upholds, and those perhaps that would not. He may be carrying with him mental, spiritual, and physical scars of that shift. And he's probably on his way home, probably in the dark, to get back to a place where no one's loved and is appreciated for simply being a human being. But we know that he's going to go back out on his next shift to uphold the law, to protect and serve. Amen? And chances are, somewhere on River Road today, there is a shift worker getting off the graveyard shift who's working 2 to 3 jobs. Getting off of this one, have a quick bite to eat, and then get ready for the second job of the day. Maybe COVID wrecked all of that. Maybe there's so few people that can work that he's having to make ends meet. Perhaps he's caring for someone else in the household. And he's tired, and he's exhausted. You might know him. You're probably at home now, getting a few hours of shut-eye before they turn around sometime this afternoon and get ready to do it all. And why did I mention all this on Easter Sunday morning? Because for a lot of our folks in our community, when they woke up early in the morning or they were coming off a shift when it was still dark, it may have felt like another day. When their motives may be questioned, where people may not appreciate them or be short with them, and they may be suffering silence and thinking that this is just another day. Brothers and sisters, if you know that person, or you find yourself in a similar situation, today was not just another day. This is Easter Sunday morning, and Jesus Christ came for all the people I mentioned, for all of you, for anybody who's ever felt pain, suffering, or injustice. This is exactly what Jesus came for. So that you, them, and all of us would never feel alone. And all this happened before the sun even came up. And why is that so important? Because according to John's scripture, most people were still in their beds. The sun hadn't come up yet. The people who yesterday were rejoicing that Jesus was dead and gone and out of their hair probably couldn't wait for a day when they didn't have to hear the preaching of this crazy man from the countryside who was going to challenge their power or their hegemony. There were probably those that were just ticked off that Jesus was getting all the attention, and they're so glad that that is now gone. There were disciples that were living with regret. They were going to wake up this morning and say, what if I have done more? Should I have run to the cross and pull him down? Should I have said that I am a friend of Jesus and not deny him 3 times? Or perhaps they're like Judas thinking I should not have betrayed him. And there's plenty of people on that Sunday morning, brothers and sisters, who were fearful of waking up because they thought the light and hope was gone out of the world. Mary Magdalene, she was full of hope, amen? According to John, she got up before the sun even came up, according to John's scripture. Chapter 20, verse 1, she went out before it was light and was going to carry on doing what she had done the day before, what she was going to do that day, and probably do the next. She was going to go and be in the presence of her Lord and Savior. She went out before it was light because she believed. And she gets there, the stone is gone, and hope is restored. And we're told she runs. Ella maybe was full blast for 2 minutes. Maybe it was once around the cemetery and into the house. She ran to tell him that he was gone. Was it out of excitement? Was it out of panic? Out of fear? She goes back with the disciples. And it's interesting that Peter and the disciple whom Jesus loved, they looked in and they believed, but nobody stopped to check on Mary. Peter and the disciple whom Jesus loved, John tells us they just went back to the house. Well, that's interesting. They believed. Well, he's risen. All right, we're going home. Of all the things to be witness to, ho-hum, oh, I guess it all is true. All right, back home, back to sleep. But John tells us Mary stayed and she was weeping. And who did Jesus meet first? The person who was in grief. Disguised as someone else, she called Mary by name. She called Mary by name. That's the beautiful part of the Easter story. Jesus came for all people, over the victory of sin and death, but really, he came for you. Ray Shepherdson, Nell Thomas, Jim Chaney, Donnie Newton, Charlie Fath, Christy Evans. God came for everybody, but all of you especially, and he calls you by name. How do I know this is all true? It's all God's likeness today. When I drove in this morning before sunrise to grab some things for communion, that police officer was parked in our parking lot. And he looked up when he saw this big old truck rolling through at 5:45. Granted, I would have had questions too. And I could tell he was watching me until I put in the code and got in the church, and so I guess he's doing well. If he can get in, it's all okay. Gave him a wave and gave me a thumbs up. And he reclined back in the seat and closed his eyes. Amen. That nurse I was talking about got home just in time to see her son open his Easter basket. And she's going back to start a couple of days consecutively this afternoon. But her Facebook message, her post was today needs us all. And for that shift worker, he was there this morning at sunrise. And he had one of the biggest smiles I saw by the lake today. Maybe it was because he was like me and could see the ducks, and some of our youth were tracking them as they flew over the lake. Gray, I was living vicariously through you. But that's where I've seen you God's eyes. an entire worn-out police officer, and an exhausted, brain-tumored nurse, and a shift worker trying to make ends meet. As much as I know that Jesus died for my sins and came to save me and came to save all of you, I'm most appreciative on a day like today that Jesus rose for those three people. The ones hurt, the ones struggle. If that's you, you are not alone. And that, brothers and sisters, is of God. That's what I want. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, this table is for you. It's for all of you. So I pray in the next few moments, as you feel led, you will come and receive the gift that God has for you and for all people at all times and in all places, the body and the cup, broken and poured out for you and for men, for the forgiveness of sin. Won't you pray with me? Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, the promised resurrection. We ask your blessing and your Holy Spirit upon these gifts of bread and cup. May them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ that is redeemed by his blood. Lord, if we have struggles with any person, place, or situation, if we hold anger or hostility, jealousy or anxiety or pain, depression, suffering of any kind in our hearts, our minds, and our bodies, Lord, now we lay them at your feet. May you make us new. May you remind us of your presence and the depth of your love for me, for my enemy, for the Lord. This is the prayer we ask in this heavenly name we pray. Amen. Brothers and sisters, we have a couple ways to receive communion today. The ushers in a few moments will direct you up. Dan and Christy are going to be also in one of our communion stations today. If you'll come up, we will break off a piece of bread for you, and you'll have a couple of options. You can have, you can dip through intention, that would be in my line, or you can use the cups here. And there's also a prepackaged at your seat. If you still want to come up for a blessing, just let me know that and I'll convey a blessing upon you. And as always, we have these altar rails for you to stop and have a moment of prayer and thanksgiving with God. So brothers and sisters, come and receive the precious gift of our Lord and Savior. For those assisting in communion, please come forward. Brothers and sisters, come and receive. Precious gift. Brothers and sisters, let us pray. Lord, for a gift we can never repay, and when thanks are not enough, we simply are in awe of your love and your spirit, which runs towards us and is ready to call us by name. Lord, may we take this, bottle it up, and share it with those in our world, that all may know that this is your day, and you are risen, risen indeed. This is the prayer we offer in our heavenly name, we pray, and all God's people said, amen. Now, for our closing hymn today, when we were putting our worship service together, and I was asking our worship committee, what closing hymn should we have? And I included our ushers in that email. And I said, I'm going to do this, but we called Rick Reed out again. And he said, Patrick, in his very matter-of-fact way, through an email, I could hear Rick saying this, he said, if we don't sing Christ the Lord is risen today, then what are we doing? What are we doing? Let's sing Christ the Lord is risen today. If you will stand, and you will join us in our closing hymn. Oh, my Lord.
We did it already.
You know, I made it all the way to like 10:59 before the day just fell apart. So, this is the song you meant, and that's sure it's not. Oh, no. So, now you've seen it, we can now celebrate Easter, so stand and sing with me, Up From the Grave.
Thank you.
stumbled over your words during a service? And I said no before I hit wood twice. So thank the Lord if there's going to be a faux pas, it will be at the end of the service, praise God. Brothers and sisters, whether you're going to sing Christ the Lord and Risen Today or Up from the Grave He Arose, don't just sing it, live it, be it. You are the examples of Jesus' resurrection. Who you are is enough. Love the heck out of you. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and all God's people said,
Amen.